Enterprise Data Management gives you two ways to output your Dimension data: Dimension Exports and Dimension Extracts. Use Exports to export data from the viewpoint or viewpoints bound to a dimension. The output is formatted specifically to be consumed by your external application. Use Extracts when you need the flexibility to control the output format and content. Extracts and exports are similar, but there are some key differences. Where exports are limited to exporting data from bound viewpoints and properties, you can create extracts for any active viewpoint and include any property, regardless of the binding status. Extracts can output data from time-labeled viewpoints, which allows you to extract viewpoint data based on a historical point in time. You cannot create exports for time-labeled viewpoints. Exports can output a full dataset for bound viewpoints. For certain application types, you can also use REST API methods to export incremental changes to bound list viewpoints. Extracts can output a full dataset, a filtered subset of data, or incremental data changes for any viewpoint. The output format and content of exports is system-defined and determined by your application registration settings. Exported data files contain target-specific logic and formatting so that they can be imported by external applications. By contrast, the format of extracted data is fully configurable with no constraints enforced by external applications. Only one export of the viewpoint or viewpoints that are bound to the dimension is available per dimension, but you can create multiple single viewpoint extracts per dimension. Depending on the application type, exports are output as text files or zip files and can be output to an application connection or a local drive. Extracts for any application type can be extracted as text files or Excel files, zipped or unzipped, and you can output them either to a local drive or a global connection, depending on your permissions. Finally, exports are restricted to users with data manager or greater permissions for the dimension. Extracts can be either public or private. Any user with participant read permission can create their own private extracts for reporting purposes. Extracts are flexible by design. By not being limited to bound viewpoints, you can consume alternate hierarchies, what-if scenarios, historical points in time with time-labeled viewpoints, or other partially bound or unbound variants of a dimension or data mapping. For example, you can extract an unbound hierarchy where you've been planning a dimension reorganization, or extract and reformat information from a viewpoint with cross-dimensional intersections. There are three types of extracts: full extracts, incremental extracts, and generational extracts. Full extracts extract all current data from a viewpoint, bound or unbound. The extract can include bound or unbound properties. For hierarchy viewpoints, you can extract nodes and their hierarchical relationships by including both the core name property and the core stats parent property in your extract. Incremental extracts enable you to extract changes made to a viewpoint between two time periods. When you create the extract, you designate from and to time periods. You can specify from and to dates, a date offset, or you can extract all changes made since the last time an extract was run. When you run the extract, the system compares viewpoint versions for the two periods and outputs the incremental differences. Note, incremental extracts are not available for time-labeled viewpoints. Generational extracts are available for hierarchy viewpoints. These extracts output the viewpoint's hierarchy relationships as separate columns in the extract, instead of parent and child columns as in the other extract types. When you create generational extracts, the system gives you extra options to control your output content. For example, whether you are extracting a property for a node or its ancestors, how many hierarchy levels to include, and separate filters for nodes and ancestor nodes. For any extract type, filter expressions enable you to create an inclusion or exclusion filter for the nodes in the extract. For example, your extract can include all nodes with an ancestor of 100 or exclude all nodes whose names start with 4. When you first create an extract, it's created as a private extract. Private extracts can only be viewed and run by the user who created them. You must have access to a view and at least participant read access to the viewpoint to create or copy a private extract. You run private extracts from the Viewpoint Extracts report list on the Reports page. This allows users to design extracts as reports that they can easily download on a repeatable basis. If you have owner or metadata manager permission on a dimension, you can promote a private extract to public so that other users can see and run it. Public extracts are visible and available to run for users with data manager or better permissions on the dimension. You cannot create a public extract directly. You can run public extracts from the applications list, the Viewpoint Extracts report, a REST API, or EPM Automate. They can be run to a local file or a global connection. Unlike exports, which can only be run one at a time, you can group extracts together into extract packages to run multiple extracts from an application with a single operation. When you run the extract package, each extract in the package is run and the results are added to a single zip file. For example, you can create an extract package that runs extracts from every dimension in an application, collecting them into a single zip file. Extract packages are public and can only contain public extracts. This video is part of a video learning series on extracting data in enterprise data management. Check the description for links to the entire series. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.